Well, good morning, everyone. This is Mr. Evans here. It's a delight to have a chance to welcome you all to the seventh grade celebration of what has been an incredible and very unique year. I think one of the things that we knew coming into the year was that doing it together was going to make us all stronger and better. And then we found out here in the spring that we really leaned into those connections that we made all year as we went online and suddenly needed to really support each other in new and completely different and unanticipated ways. But I'll tell you, I was in and out of a lot of different Zoom classes, and many of them in the seventh grade, and you all were spectacular. You really took on what was some challenging circumstances and did just a terrific job with it. And so my congratulations to you on not only having this unique experience, but mastering this unique experience and coming out on the other side, a stronger class, a more connected class, and one that is as ready for eighth grade as any group of seventh graders we have seen. So congratulations, want you to have a terrific summer, want you to listen carefully to this ceremony because you're gonna hear about so many of your classmates and have a chance to celebrate them and know that we all have a part in that. So congratulations, and let's get on with our celebration.
That was awesome, band. Now for our prayer, James Irwin will lead us.
Please join me in prayer. Dear God, thank you for the opportunity to gather today to reflect on such a memorable school year. It did not turn out as we thought it would, but we have a lot to celebrate and to be grateful for today. Thank you for the many ways we learned through the unexpected and grew through perseverance in our connections with one another. We ask your blessing on this hour we have with our class, teachers, and advisors. May we all come together to celebrate our community in a way that honors you, God, and honors all that we have accomplished through you. May our hearts be filled with with gratitude for one another and for our school. Amen.
Thank you, James. We do indeed have so much to be thankful for, and we're excited to be able to celebrate the year together. Next, we're going to have Kayla Cheney to share our scripture.
This is a reading from Proverbs chapter 3, verses 1 through 6. My child, do not forget my teaching, but keep my commands in your heart, for they will prolong your life many years and bring you peace and prosperity. Let love and faithfulness never leave you. Bind them around your neck and write them on a tablet of your heart. Then you will win favor and a good name in the sight of God and people. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge God, and he will make your paths straight. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Kayla. We're going to begin now with a few recognitions and special awards, and we'll start with Ms. Little sharing the highest academic distinction awards.
It's my privilege to present to you the names of those students who have earned highest academic distinction. Throughout this year, you have maintained an exceptional standard of scholarship. The effort you have demonstrated represents an investment in your growth and distinguishes you as a learner. By your diligence, you have duly earned this honor. The Westminster Middle School is pleased to recognize you for this distinction. Please join me in celebrating these fine students and their exceptional achievement.
Congratulations!
Woo!
Congratulations!
All right,
good
way
job.
To go.
Awesome.
Good job, guys.
Good job,
seventh grade
girls.
Good job, everybody.
Seventh grade boys.
Yay!
Congrats, guys.
Good
job. Boys, good job.
Congrats, guys.
Fantastic. Nice.
That was just beautiful, Chorus. We have a number of special awards to be given this morning. The first are our citizenship awards, the recipients of which demonstrate loyalty to school, a willingness to help others, a strong effort in extracurricular activities, good conduct, friendliness, and they represent their class well. To present this year's seventh grade citizenship awards, here are Dr. Cochran and Ms. Allen.
For the seventh grade girls award, it has been said that being of service to others is what brings true happiness. This year's seventh grade girls citizenship award winner, nominated both by her teachers and peers, simply loves people and our planet. She puts her whole heart into making this world a better place. Her sincere kindness is a model for all, and her teachers relay how she has a way of making everyone feel known and cared for. With an ever-present smile, she brings a joyful spirit to every space she enters. She has been commended for her diligence with classwork and her positive approach to learning. this young lady gives her best effort. Outside of the classroom this year, she participated in cross country and track and field, helped start the Echo Ecology Club, and was involved in numerous service projects. Through her commitment to her academics, her extracurricular activities, her teachers, and her peers, she truly does make our middle school a better place. This year's seventh grade Girls Citizenship Award winner is Claire Diaz.
Yeah.
Claire.
Yeah, that fits.
Thank you, Ms. Allen. Rather than focusing solely on what Westminster can do for them as an individual, good citizens try to figure out what they can do for their fellow students at Westminster. While they do take advantage of the opportunities given to them, they equally strive to ensure their fellows have access to those same opportunities and seize them. The winner of the Citizenship Award for the boys in the seventh grade this year models this as well as, if not better, than anyone I have ever known. He has spent the entire year thinking of ways to enhance his peers' experience at school, putting those plans into action, and generally making the community better for all of its members. This young man truly embodies the charge of a middle school class representative, and he shines the spotlight on others. He is the type of citizen we should all aspire to be, and it has been my great honor to work with Will Samedy.
Hey, Will!
Way to go, brother.
Way to go, Citizenship Award winners. I have the pleasure of sharing two additional named awards that are unique to seventh grade. The first is Steve and Reba Bomar Award. This award was established in 2003 by former Westminster parents, Linda and Randy Tye, and their children, John, class of 91, Steve, class of 93, and Anna, class of 99. This award is given in memory of Ms. Tye's parents, Steve and Reba Bomar, both of whom exemplified a strong sense of commitment to helping others, a positive work ethic, and the ability to generally make a better place for those around them. The Bomar Award is given to a seventh grader who has demonstrated throughout all areas of school life integrity, a strong character, a willingness to work hard, and a predisposition to excel in ways that make Westminster a better place. This year's Bomar Award recipient earns the admiration of his teachers and peers for his work ethic and personal achievements. He approaches school with the utmost respect for himself, for others, and for Westminster's values. His contributions to the community are notable and varied. He was a driving force behind the robotics team's successful run, and he is a diligent, effective class representative. Above all, like the award's namesakes, this year's recipient is a good friend who generally makes a better place for those around him. We look forward to his continued leadership in the middle school. We are delighted to present this year's Steve and Reba Bomar Award to Augie Bunting.
Hey, Augie!
Woohoo!
Congratulations, Augie.
499.
Next, I'm pleased to present the William A. Parker Senior Student Improvement Award. This award was established to recognize annually a seventh grade student who demonstrates outstanding improvement in academics, superb personal growth in both personality and character, and strong involvement and participation in extracurricular activities such as community service, athletics, fine arts, and general interaction with fellow students. Over the course of his 2 years in middle school, this year's seventh grade Parker Award recipient has shown great determination and growth. He is a creative thinker with passion for all things STEAM and a heart for service. Balancing all of the demands of middle school, along with his many interests and personal projects, has been challenging for him. However, with each year, he has shown marked improvement and is finding his stride. a key contributor to WCAT and the Innovation Lab, we look forward to his leadership next year as an eighth grader in the middle school community. It is a pleasure to present the William A. Parker Sr. Student Improvement Award for seventh grade to Buckley Wiley.
Buckley!
Hey, Buckley.
Congratulations, Buckley. Now, there are a series of awards that are unique to eighth grade and that you can look forward to next year. We presented them earlier this morning to our eighth grade in their celebration, and we wanted to share those with you today. Please join us in congratulating all of our eighth grade winners. And if you saw any friends in that montage, feel free to send them a little note of congratulations yourself. It's hard to believe that we are at our final assembly, but indeed we are. Seventh graders, you've done it, you've made it, you are through with seventh grade. And to welcome you to the eighth grade, I'd love to introduce your grade chairs for next year, Ms. Zido and Mr. Egan.
Hello, class of 2025. It's official. You're done with seventh grade. So we're here to welcome you to eighth grade. I am Mr. Egan.
And I am Ms. Zido. We are your new grade chairs, and we are so excited to work with you and get to know you all better.
In your final year in the middle school, you will have new teachers to meet, new spaces to explore, and new opportunities to experience.
Eighth graders love the expanded leadership opportunities and independence they have in classes, sports, clubs, and the visual and performing arts. And Mr. Egan and I will be by your side, supporting you on the final leg of your Clarkson Hall journey.
We charge you to take time in the next couple of months to envision who you want to be and how you want to lead as an eighth grader. A fresh start awaits us all in August.
More than anything, we're excited to congratulate you all on a seventh grade. Well done. And we want to welcome you to eighth grade. We wish you a happy summer, and we'll see you in August.
Happy summer.
Yay.
Thank you.
That was really beautiful orchestra. Now to follow, Kendall Hermanson will offer a prayer.
Please pray with me. Dear God, thank you so much for bringing us here today to celebrate our final moments together as the school year comes to an end. Help us to look back on all the memories we have made, the hard times we've gotten through, and the times where we thought we weren't going to make it. Help us to recognize the mistakes we have made in the past as a sign of growth as a person and as a community. God, we thank you for blessing us with all the remarkable opportunities of this school year and for the people who were there for us along the way. Thank you for our families, teachers, advisors, coaches, and friends, for all the people who loved us and led us through this year. As this school year comes to an end, help us to be all the more grateful for what we have and all the more aware of the world around us and what we can do to make it better. In your name we pray, amen.
Amen.
Was just beautiful orchestra. I'm sorry, chorus. In my mind. We began this year with the theme and goal at 650. While we never would have wished for or predicted a global crisis, we knew from the very outset that connection was foundational to our success. Every year of life has its ups and downs, its surprises and challenges. Each of us survives and thrives, not just because of our individual strength, but because we live in communities. We support each other, and we thrive when we make others a priority, when we take time to notice, engage, collaborate, to connect. Over the past 2 months, not much has mattered besides our connections. We have seen firsthand why community is so important. Thank you for being an awesome community. Thank you for being a friend to others, supportive of your teachers and coaches, for being engaged in the groups, the teams, the activities that make Westminster a vibrant place. As you transition to summer seventh grade, now eighth grade, be assured that Westminster is only taking a rest. We will be back, Wildcat strong, and ready for another great school year in August, hopefully in person. For now, it's time for a well-deserved, well-earned break from schoolwork. Time to rest, read, reflect, and relax. So go with gratitude, Wildcats, taking this unusual summer one day at a time, counting blessings, looking for silver linings, and practicing gratitude every single day. Gratitude truly is a superpower. Now, to remind us of the many reasons we have to be grateful for the 2019-20 school year, here are a few highlights that have been compiled for us by Mr. FC and Ms. Madison.
Into the sun, there is more to see than can ever be seen, or to do than can ever be done.
Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you.
That's what friends are supposed to do, oh yeah. Ooh.
keep you close as always. It won't even seem you've gone, 'cause our hearts in big and small ways will keep the love that keeps us strong.
Miss Madison, for putting all of that together for us. Well, seventh grade, it is time. It's time to get ready for summer. Before you run off into the sunset, we're going to ask you to do one more thing. We'd love for you to join your homeroom. So please, as you leave this meeting, you're going to follow your advisor's link to join homeroom for one final touch point before the school year ends. We love you, and we look forward to seeing you again in August. Bye, everybody.
Yay. Have a good summer.